In this series of stacked graphs, we want to look at the pressure, flow, and velocity of blood as it traverses the systemic circuit. At the top here, we have an anatomical representation of that circuit, of that pathway of blood through that cardiovascular circuit. We would start in the aorta, a single vessel. We would move into branching and numerous arteries. And then we move into the small, the microvessels, the arterioles, the capillaries, and the venules. These are found in the billions, enormous numbers of them. The blood then coalesces out of the capillaries and venules into the larger veins, and then finally back into the vena cava, the vessels that return blood fluid to the heart to be repressurized and sent off to the pulmonary circuit. Now, if we come down below here and look at our first graph, let's look at blood pressure. The pressure is highest as we come out of the heart, right? The ventricle was generating this pressure, so that's highest, closest to the heart. It's going to fall with distance from the heart due to friction with the blood vessels. We have pulsatile pressure in the aorta and the larger arteries due to our ejection of blood from the ventricle being intermittent. The cardiac cycles occur with ejection phases and then relaxing and filling phases. And when we eject blood, we peak the volume in the arterial circuit and we get a systolic pressure. And then in between, when the heart is relaxing and filling, the pressure in the arterial circuit is falling and we get our diastolic pressure shown here. Now what we find is that in the large arteries, the pressure stays fairly constant. But then we get to the arterioles and pressure is going to fall dramatically. We have a much increased resistance to flow there, and so our pressure falls dramatically entering the capillaries here. That's very important. Capillaries are exceptionally thin-walled, tiny vessels. They cannot sustain large transmural pressures. And so the pressure has to fall before it gets to them. Then, of course, the blood comes out of those capillaries and has to return to the heart through the veins. These are very low-pressure portion of the circuit. They actually have valves to prevent backflow. The pressure is so low. Now, if we come down one more trace here, we're going to look at flow. And let's focus on the blue line here, the blue being the mean flow. What we find is that flow through each of the segments of the cardiovascular circuit have to be equal. We cannot have more flow through one segment than the other over time, otherwise blood is backing up somewhere. Now, flow will be pulsatile in those large arteries, and that's again because we're ejecting blood and then we aren't, and then we're ejecting again. So the flow rate actually spikes and falls. But that will dissipate at the farther we move out that circuit. We come down one more trace. We look at total cross-sectional area. On the left here, we have the aorta. It has very small cross-sectional area, right? It's a single vessel. The vena cava on the opposite side, right? There's only two of them, a superior and an inferior. And together, they have a very small total cross-sectional area. What you find in the middle, though, in these microvessels, is that we have an enormous cross-sectional area. This is very important because, A, we have to have a large surface area for diffusion, but it's also going to dramatically affect the flow rate through this segment of the cardiovascular circuit. So let's come down here and look at that. The velocity of blood flow. Again, pulsatile in the large arteries because of the ejection and relaxation phases of the heart. But if we look at our mean velocity, it's very high in our large arteries. It's very high in the vena cava. Velocity is proportional to 1 over the total cross-sectional area. The aorta over here and the vena cava over here have very small cross-sectional areas. Very small area, very high velocity. That's getting blood out to the tissues quickly and back from those tissues very quickly. That's important. We're not doing any gas exchange, any nutrient exchange in these larger vessels. That all occurs in the capillaries. Let's look at those capillaries. Their total cross-sectional area is enormous, right? Look at the flow rate. Again, inversely proportional. If the total cross-sectional area is huge, then the velocity is very slow. This is essential as it allows time for that diffusion to occur. Capillaries are less than a millimeter in length. Blood traverses them in less than 1 second. Yet we reach equilibration, diffusive equilibration, of gases and solutes and other things so that we maintain tissue homeostasis, so that low flow rate in the capillaries is highly adaptive.